So here's my implementation of the resampling step, and it follows the same logic that I gave you in the diagram. We're creating a new set of particles called P3, and it's an empty set in the beginning. And inside this routine, every time I resample, I add a particle from the previous particle set with the index. So that's the main loop over here. And in the end, I assign P3 back to P. So that's the resampling step. My very first index is drawn at random. This is a uniform random sampler of all the indices. And then I have this running variable better that I set to 0.0. And I cache away the max of the W just to be slightly faster. You don't have to do this. They're coming over here. Doesn't really matter. You could have max over here. But then I go and produce exactly n particles. And the way I do this, I add to better a uniform random that is twice as large in maximum in the range as my max weight W. Now, 2 times max weight W would be a very large step, but by adding a random variable that sits between 0 and 1, I have a uniform between 0 and 2 times MW. And then, while this beta variable is larger than the weight of the current index, I subtract this weight from my beta value, and I increment index by 1 modulo n, the total number of particles. And when it's smaller, I'm done. I can just take that particle, add it, append it, and repeat. So this entire procedure over here is somewhat involved. If you got that right, I'm impressed. I hope you learned something from doing it. It happens to be really easy to program once you know what to do. And every time you run a particle filter, you can just reuse it. You never have to think about it again because there's nothing domain specific in the specific procedure over here. So let's run it. If I run it, nothing happens. Turns out empty set. So let me print out the resulting set of particles. So now it has a print P over here. Let me run it. And of course, I'm going to get 1,000 particles, right? A lot of particles. But let me look through them. If you just look at the first value over here, they're all about the same. They're all between 76 and 82. The second one, they're all about 42, 44, 43, 41, 39, 38. So what you've gotten here is a set of particles that are all co-located. So instead of having a complete random set of particles that we had before, the resampling step, you can see this, already gives me particles with very similar x and y positions. Now it turns out the orientations are not very similar. They're jumped like crazy. And the reason is, well, if you think about it, we only have one location so far. Our distances to landmarks are independent of the orientation. So as a result, orientation plays no role in the projected measurement and therefore has no role in the selection. Let me make the point again. Here's our 4 landmarks and we measure the distances to those. A robot facing this direction has a certain set of distances. A robot facing a different direction, like this one, has the exact same set of distances. Therefore, in our particle filter, the heading direction plays no role.